Welcome to fifth lesson on matrices in MATLAB. Let me take a matrix, a simple matrix, a 3x3 matrix as shown here. Now there are some important operators in the MATLAB. The two in the matrices. Suppose I need to have a transpose of this matrix. So transpose of a matrix is nothing but changing of rows to columns and columns to rows. So these things I am going to be stored in the B variable as A transpose. Simply you can able to observe that the row is replaced to column in the B matrix. So this is a simple transpose of an array. Now I need to display the first row in this particular matrix, A matrix. Now that one I am going to store in the C variable as C is equal to A of 1, colon. And this is the colon operator which I am going to separate the first row of the matrix A like this. The first row of the matrix A is going to be stored in the matrix C. Like that I can do it for the second row also. Second row I will store it in the D, like C. D is equal to A of 2, colon, where it will take the second row and it is going to be stored in the D. Next I will go for E is equal to A of 3, colon, and the third row is also going to be served. Similarly for column, earlier wise we have seen the row wise, now we will go for the column wise. So for storing these values in the column wise also, now I am going to store in the F, A of, there is a small change, observe, A of semicolon of 1, sorry, A of colon comma 1. Colon operator will separate now the column matrix. If I try to press the enter, 147. So this 147 we have got here, this one is stored in the F value. Like that, I will go to store in the G variable as A of colon comma 2. Second column, I am going to be stored in the H variable. I am going to store A of colon comma 3. Like this, all the three things I am going to be stored. So this is the case where I am going to separate row wise or separate column wise. So next case is, now I need to have only in the row or only one particular element. For in this particular matrix, I need to get this two value. So the two value is in first row and second column. So that is 1 and 2. So now what I am going to be stored is the value of 2 I am going to be stored in the B variable as A of 1, 2. That value will be stored here. Suppose I need to have this 6 value. So 6 is in second row, third column. Second row, third column. So simply I will go that one and store it in C as A of second row, third column. I am going to store it. So like this I can able to store multiple number of cases. And the next one is, I am going to estimate the size. So what is the size of this one? So basically the size is needed to note by the programmer. So the size of this particular A is a 3x3 matrix. And what about the length of this matrix? So length, basically it will try to say, it will return the maximum size of the matrix. For example, here the maximum size is 3. So it will return the value as 3. Thank you.